turning the tides my ass. More like lining your own pockets, you slimy shit.
What the hell are you... Ah, Biddle.
Oopsie-daisy.
You sent 24 National Guardsmen to their deaths for a paycheck. When the president gets wind of this, you're a dead man.
Oh, I'm sorry. It's just that the way the veins in your forehead are throbbing, it's so comical.
Mr. Assistant Secretary, these accusations sound serious, and...
First of all, it's Mr. Secretary now. As in Secretary of War. As in the fucking right hand of God. Secondly, do you think the President of these United States is gonna give a royal fuck about the pissant accusations of a podunk? Go ahead, Rentier, do it. Give me a reason to throw your cowpoke ass into Newgate and flens your father's legacy to the bone. The Harrow Institute has a much better ring to it, don't you think?
Mr. Secretary, maybe it would be for the best if you...
Maybe it would be best if you stopped interrupting me, you groveling mule! You want to make yourself useful? Get to the kitchen and fetch me a cup of coffee! Now fuck off and find some vampires to kill. That's much more your speed. You want something done right?
Okay.
Do you really feel war is coming? Full-blown war with the Ticks? You know, Dr. Blackwell deserves far more respect than those bureaucrats are giving her.
The news is spreading fast.
Anchor pushers in D.C.
Yeah, well, I bet they wouldn't be so cocky if a Tick came knocking on the White House door.
Probably not, but that would mean we failed.
That's alarming.
But how did you manage to extend its longevity?
I'm surprised voltage that high didn't burn it out.
It's all about the percentage of copper in the alloy. Here, I'll show you my notes.
Seriously? I would love to see your original research. It would be an honor.
Virgil and I were just having the most invigorating discussion.
I was telling Director Rentier about my ideas for upgrading the gauntlet.
I must say, it's refreshing to see young blood like Mr. Olney's coursing through Calico. We'll need his vital spirit if we're to rebuild the Institute's power and vigor. Well done, son.
I think we may have given him a few too many vaults.
Glad to see you're in good shape, but we've got a situation. In order to keep your condition quiet, Amelia told Harrow you died. He's pulled rank and is sending us out on money-grubbing errands while Felicity's building her army.
Harrow's head knows what's right, but his heart is tainted by lust for power and money.
It's gonna get worse now that he got promoted. One wrong move and we're dead in the water.
The one right move, and you could catch her and end this war. On the subject of moving...
You know what? Maybe let's wait for the doc to give the all clear before we start unbinding anyone.
Oh, Edgar. Harrow's not an idiot. Without the Institute, this country would turn into a blood feast. Now, you tell me, son. What's more important? His approval or ending this war before it started?
What did you see while Felicity was in your head?
Death. Horrible monsters appearing out of nowhere. Fire, smoke, everything. And boxcars. Scores of them. Filled with blood.
That's how she's transporting the leeches now?
By train?
That's not good, sirs. Dickinson is a major cattle railway hub. The trains run in all directions. If there's an outbreak, we won't be able to contain it.
Jesus Christ, what happened here?
after he follows.
I wanted to show you how my new gauntlet works.
You may have tamed the lightning and laid tracks across the continent, but you're still the same violent beasts you've always been. You just invented bigger and better clubs. I was lying in the street, sinking into the mud, sick and feverish and waiting for death. In that moment, I realized that humanity does not evolve at all. Humans are both weak and cruel. Those on top will always exploit those they consider their inferiors. Those who have nothing will continue to do all the work, while those who have everything will do none of it.
Between you and me, you little leech. Let them go.
Humans build empires in the name of progress, with no thought spared for those paying the mortal cost of their quest for glory. That is true vampirism! My kind would never leave one of their children to die, crying in the gutter.
I won't let you turn them.
You don't listen! They don't matter, Jesse Rentier. The sooner you understand that, the better.
What now? You too scared to face me in your own flesh?
Humanity exists within cycles. If you
burn it. The pendulum may swing left and right, but ultimately things remain the same. Exploitation, pain, and misery. It may look different, but it persists. The only way out is to break that pattern.
She's still here, which means the transports aren't ready. Must have caught her off guard. And now she's scared I might be able to stop her. Good.
Relationship between the hunter and its prey. It's an understanding. Women have different Jesse's ideas.
Bodies. You stack
those people somewhere, you crazy witch!
was born into pain and misery. Shunned, ignored, exploited. Waving hand and foot on those with inherited wealth. We survived so they could thrive. I was barely living and hoping to die when he found me and gave me a choice. The only price I had to pay was giving up the memory of human warmth. To begin my new life, I had to bury my past.
Got you now. train's about to leave the station. Do you hear them singing? That's humanity's requiem. You can be mankind's last sad note, or you can be part of a new opening chord of progress. It's only natural to feel fear while standing on the precipice of change. Sometimes what you need is a little push. Try not to kill him, my child. Let it break poor William's heart.
Thank you. adapt